Hey guys, so I'm here on a bit of a dark and gloomy day. Today would normally be the day that I do my 36-week pregnancy update, but I'm actually going to do it tomorrow. Now, tomorrow I do turn 37 weeks, but I'm going to do the update tomorrow. My wife delivery pack will be arriving. So I kind of want to do a film that incorporates kind of what comes in there. I don't know if I'm allowed, I'm assuming I can take everything out. And then on Tuesday as well, I will be getting my birth pool delivered. So I don't know whether to do a video that just combines the two or to do it separately. I'm kind of like really excited, but either way, I do see the midwife tomorrow morning, so I wanted to do an update tomorrow, even though, like I said, I'm 37 weeks, but I won't actually be in the 37 weeks. I'm getting really anxious, actually. Yeah, it's just gone really quick, and I am really anxious. This week has been filled with a lot of anxiety, and lots of issues have cropped up, so I will be talking about that as well. I wanted to do a video that was a bit more lighthearted today, and not that any of my other videos are not lighthearted, but basically Sebastian's sibling pack or sibling gift. And this is going to be a gift that the new baby will be giving to Sebastian. And Chris really wants to take Sebastian out, just him and just those two, and buy a gift from Sebastian to the baby. So this is just something that I've put together from the baby to Sebastian. There's a lot of videos of this online, and I did get a few ideas off a few people. So one of the ideas was a book, and it was from Sarah, This Mama's Life. I think she's a channel mum as well. I think she may have just had her baby. I've only just started following her, so but that idea came from her, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you now. And I've also bought a few other bits as well. I've been doing a bit of hauling, so I thought I'd do a mini haul as well. Okay, so here is the pack that I've bought for Sebastian. It's literally just basically a basket from IKEA. This is just one I had lying about that's handy. There's not actually a lot in it because I didn't want Sebastian to kind of get like overwhelmed with toys. As you guys may have seen before, and I'll probably link it in the description, but I have also put him together a nursing box, and this is a box that of toys, a little knick-knacky type toys that he can do and activities he can do while I'm nursing. Now, we have got Christmas coming up as well, so he's probably going to get more then. But to be honest, we were having a talk, me and Chris, about the amount of toys that Sebastian has, and I'm at the point now where I've condensed them down to what he kind of does use. Still some stuff he doesn't use, but I don't really care how much he gets, because if it entertains him during the winter months when I'm sat at home and there's not a lot to do, then I'm fine with that. I'm totally fine, even if the house is full of toys he doesn't play with, as long as there'll always be something that he wants. Anyway, I'll run through the box. So the first thing I got was this little doggy. Now, I didn't actually know his name. I need to go through the animals from this. This is from The Secret Life of Pets. I saw this film being advertised and I thought, oh, we really need to see it. And so we went to get a Happy Meal once, and in the Happy Meal was the little hamster that's in The Secret Life of Pets. And I didn't really know much about the film at the time. And because I had a hamster when I was a little girl called Squishy, I said, oh, his name's Squishy. So we started to call this hamster Squishy. And Sebastian loves it. It's a tiny little hamster, and he loves to carry it around. He called the film Squishy's Friends because it's all his friends. So he doesn't call it The Secret Life of Pets. He calls it Squishy's Friends. And he really likes the film, and he will know, you know, when he sees things out in the shop, he goes, oh, Squishy's Friends, Squishy's Friends. So hopefully he'll really like this. I also got a Frozen. He really likes Frozen at the moment. I got him a torch, and I figured this would be quite good if he wants to kind of read at night or read in the morning, like if he gets up before his glow clock and he can just turn it up. I was going to get like a little hook on the side. I don't even know if this is a good idea for a toddler, but I was going to get like a little plastic stick-on hook on the side of his wardrobe, because his bed kind of goes into a nook inside of his wardrobe, and then hang this up so that he can kind of use it to get in, you know, turn it on and off to get in and out of our room. I'm a Spider-Man. I got him that, and I think it's just like one of those surprise, it's got sweets in it and some toys and surprises. I might add a few more bits in it, I'm not sure. We'll see. I might take some of the... No, I think that should be enough, actually. Got this, and this is the idea that I got off another YouTube mum, and it's called Snuggle the Baby, and it's really nice. Sebastian has already started looking at this book, and basically it's like one of these flip-up books, and he, you know, it's all about kind of, all about kind of like, you know, things that you do, and it does tie, because I was a bit... I don't want Sebastian to think that all babies are just bottle fed, because obviously we do plan to breastfeed, but it does explain that to you, them here, and I have explained it to Sebastian that mummy will be feeding the baby with her boobie, as well as maybe with the bottle as well if I express or whatever, just so he knows. You know, and there's lots of, he can learn to take the nappy on and off, that's kind of sticky, and wrap the baby up. You get the idea. This baby comes out and you can move her around and put her in the blanket. And yeah, so Sebastian really likes this book. It's a really nice little book to read kind of just before bed, but this is also going to go in there. That's Sebastian's sibling pack. It's probably not a lot and it's probably not as inspiring as other people's, but like I said, I didn't want to go too mad because he does have the nursing box and it is Christmas. So I don't know, I may add a few things in time, but I think probably we'll stick to what's in there. Thought I'd just do another little quick haul as well of things I've been buying today. I did eventually get around to buying the H&M nursing vests. Here they are. Now you might think, oh, this is just an normal, ordinary nursing vest, but actually it has a hidden support, a hidden kind of bra type thing in it. And this is a sort of bra that you kind of want to wear when you first have your baby. So when your milk first comes in, like a sleep bra basically, just because you do get really engorged. You don't want anything that's too constricting, you don't want anything that's too kind of tight. And it does offer a good amount of support, and that it's great for sleep time because you get the support as well as the coverage on your tummy if you know, especially if it's cold. I know a lot of people whose, oh, my phone keeps going off. I know a lot of people whose supply has established and they're able to just wear this with some nursing pads, and it's kind of easier just to do the one up, one down with this than clip two, you know, a nursing top and a nursing bra. So these are really, really good, and I highly recommend these, and I will be putting these in my just in case hospital bag. I also bought this from Poundland. This is a oil burner, because I was given some clary sage oil this week. Now if you guys don't know what clary sage oil is, well, I don't really know what it is, but it's basically just an oil that is supposed to really help bring on control. I don't know if it induces labor, nothing can really bring on labor, but it's supposed to really help your contractions keep going rather than if they were to slow down. I have been given some almond oil to mix with it, and I assumed that you could mix the two and rub it on your belly, but our NCT teacher told us yesterday that we can't do that, or we shouldn't do that. So I bought one of these to start burning, and I'm probably going to start burning some lavender oil as well, just because it's very relaxing and kind of helps everybody, you know, just before bedtime, Sebastian's bedtime, I might burn some lavender oil, see if that helps him relax a bit. Not very exciting. I bought an advent calendar. I am quite prepared. I have bought Sebastian some Christmas presents this year, and I bought an advent calendar. And of course it is The Secret Life of... It's Squishy's friends, or The Secret Life of Pets. Look, there's Squishy there. I really need to find out what their actual names are. If anybody knows, let me know. But Sebastian also, I recently purchased this little rose house for Sebastian, and at the back it's like, it's all the little people in there. And this is by Happy Land. Now, Sebastian is starting to really like Happy Land. I did have a few things before that he wasn't really playing with, but his imagination play is starting to really come out now, and it's wonderful to see. And basically what he's doing is he'll go into his room and he'll start playing and he'll start making the toys talk to each other, and it's the most amazing thing to see your child do that. The Happy Land stuff is really expensive. I would highly recommend you were to get it secondhand if you did. I bought that house for £10. Now brand new it's £50, and for £50, Sebastian does not play it nowhere near enough or appreciate it nowhere near enough to have spent that much money. £50 is a lot of money for a little house. We have been trying to collect some bits secondhand that is Happy Land for him. I have for Christmas got him like the whole town as well, like a whole like town with like little tracks and stuff, and like little houses and things so that he can play, and I got that for £30 on eBay, so that was like a humongous bargain. Another thing that we got this week as well was the carry cot. We bought this again off a friend secondhand. I couldn't justify the price new because A, they're in it for a very short amount of time. Even though Sebastian was in his for a long time, he hated it at first because of his reflux. But I decided to go ahead and get this one off a friend because it was a good price. I know her, it was brand new, practically brand new. She only used it for like a short amount of time with her little one. It's a lovely colour, and it's also suitable for overnight stay. So that was something that really kind of was a plus for us, because although the co-sleeper we have can be used for overnight stay, this is a lot smaller, so while they're really little, we can just kind of chuck it and bung it in the car. So that's pretty much it, really, for this video. It's kind of a bit of a, it's not like a very long video at all, but just kind of a little update of what I've been kind of buying, and I will be doing my 36-week update tomorrow, as I said. And I guess I'll see you guys soon. Bye!